Congratulations! Starting your own business is an exciting time. After all, you're about to become your own boss. All while doing something you're passionate about. By now, you'll understand that there is a lot to do, like getting your business plan together, creating a marketing plan, registering your business name, and finding a place to run your business from. Then there's the insurance. If you're like a lot of other business owners, you'll think it can wait until later, right? Wrong. It's something every sensible business owner needs to sort out sooner rather than later. Just like, you wouldn't drive your car around without insurance because you can't predict when an accident will happen. You need to insure your business from incidents too. Because every day, businesses like yours are exposed to all kinds of risks. And just like car accidents, you can't predict when or where they'll occur. Having the right insurance doesn't remove these risks, but it does provide financial protection from the things you can't control, like fire, theft, or someone taking legal action against your business. So what kind of insurance do you need? Well, it depends on a number of things, like the kind of business you run, the size of your business, and the industry that you're in, as well as the type of risks you're exposed to. It's an essential part of ensuring your business can manage financially if something goes wrong. There's a range of different insurances available to cover you and your business against slips, falls, and other accidents, property loss or damage, natural disasters, claims of negligence, financial loss, and cybercrime. But don't panic. You don't need to insure everything. To understand what you should insure, firstly assess the risks to your business and what your potential exposure is against them. That is, how much would it cost your business if that particular risk occurred? You should then look to insure the things your business couldn't afford to cover if they occurred, the ones that could put your business on the line. For example, a personal trainer might decide it's not worth insuring his equipment as he could afford to buy new equipment if it got damaged, lost, or destroyed. But if one of his clients or even a member of the public was injured as a result of him training his clients, it could cost him thousands of dollars in compensation costs, which he simply couldn't afford to pay. Even if the chances of it happening are low, he would protect himself and his business by getting public liability cover. It's important to remember that some types of insurance are compulsory by law, like if you're an accountant, real estate agent, or a finance broker, you must have professional indemnity insurance. You'll probably also find that you're required to hold insurance to rent a premise, enter into some contracts, or even hold a membership to certain industry groups. As a NEIS participant, you're required to hold and maintain public liability insurance as a minimum for your business. One thing's for sure, having the right insurance could mean the difference between staying in business or going out of business if something major happens.